The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 8th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on June 7th, 1974, in Geneva, Switzerland.
Ujjanuvasa, kim tad brahma kim adhyatmam, kim karma prusutama, adhibhutam sakim puruktam, adhidaivam kim uchyate. These are the subject matter of knowledge. Ke brahma. Brahma means the biggest. Vinanatya, vihatya. Biggest, it is already biggest. And still increasing. That is called Brahma. So, this cosmic universe, it is already the biggest, but it is increasing. That is also scientific, modern science. It is, the statement is already scientific. Modern science also, they say that the universe is increasing. So Brahma means the biggest. So our Vaishnava philosophy, biggest means Krishna, because he is the richest, he is the strongest, he is the wisest, he is the most beautiful. In this way, he is the biggest. We also calculate, if anyone is very rich, we consider he is the biggest man in the society. But nobody can hold all the riches of the world. Krishna can hold. Krishna has got all the riches of the world. Sarva Loka Maheshwaram. Krishna says, I am the Maheshwaram, the supreme owner of all the planets. So actually, Krishna is Parabrahma. He is not only Brahma, but Parabrahma. That is accepted. Kim adhyatmam? Atma. Atma means this body, Atma means this self, Atma means the mind. But Arjuna is asking, what is the real meaning of Atma? Atma means the soul. You are also Atma, I am also Atma, every one of us. The minute particle, part and parcel of Krishna. Kim karma? This karma means to work. That is material. Working is required in the material world. Without working, you cannot get anything. Here, you have to maintain your body and soul together. Therefore, you have to work. So work can be divided in different ways, but one has to work. One may work as a brahmana, one may work as a kshatriya, one may work as a vaishya or a shudra. So work is there. Without working, it is just opposite. Without working, without any endeavor, you can live eternally. That is Vaikuntha loka. Vaikuntha means without any anxiety. Here, we are full of anxieties. Purushottama. Arjuna addressed Krishna as Purushottama, Uttama Purush. There are three kinds of Purushas. Purusha means the male or the angel. So, Uttama Purush, Madhyama Purush, Adhama Purush. Adhama means the lowest. We are also Purusha. At least we have taken the position of Purusha to enjoy this material world. But we are Adhama Purusha. Adhama means the lowest. We cannot enjoy independently. We require so many favorable circumstances. Just like we cannot see without the sunrise. Still, we are very much proud of seeing. We say, can you show me God? Can you see God? You cannot see without sunshine, and still you are so much proud of your eyes. That is called Adhama. He has no knowledge, still he is taking PhD degree and getting Nobel Prize. This is going on. So, Krishna is the Purushottam, Uttama Purusha. The Madhyama Purusha is the super soul. Vayamidya, between Krishna and we are Adhama Purusha. So Krishna is addressed as Uttama Purusha. The best of all Purushas are enjoyed. Adhibhutam, the matter, five elements of matter. King Proktam, which of them are for the Brahma, Atma, everything, Arjuna wanted to know from Krishna. Krishna, he has accepted Krishna, the spiritual master, and spiritual master means the authority. Unless you accept somebody as quite fit for becoming your authority, he cannot become spiritual master. You must be satisfied by the authoritative statement of the spiritual master. You cannot argue. That is the principle of authority. Asi Daivam, the demigods. The demigods, they are controlling the universal affairs. Just like for rain, water supply, Indra Dev, the demigod known as Indra, he is in charge. For heat and light, the demigod Surya Dev, he is in charge. Similarly, the moon, Chandradev, they are all devas, demigods. He is in charge of what is called activating the vegetables, the moon, activating the vegetables. In this way, all these demigods have got different power invested upon them by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They are agents. They are called demigods, Indra, Chandra. There are 33 crores of demigods. And they are controlling our activities also. The astronomy means the astral influence upon us. And according to the astral influence, we act. Therefore, horoscope is made. At the time of birth, a person's situation according to different astral influence, and then the astrology science can make his horoscope, his future activities, his future hopes, everything is done. Then Adhijagga. Adhijagga, where the Supreme Personality of God, Narayana or Vishnu, Adhijagga, Patham Kotra, this means Madhusudana. Where the Adhijagga, super soul, living within this body. Prayane kale cha patham jnayasi niyatakma vi. Niyatatmavi. Those who are yogis or devotees, how do they meditate upon you? And at the time of death, pranakale, how he passes away. Bhagavan Uvacha, Bhagavan replied, Aksharam Brahma Paramam Sabhava Adhyatam Uchyate Bhuta Bhavat Bhavo Karo Vishatka Karma Sangrita Adhi Bhutam Charo Bhava Purushascha Adhidaivatam Adhi Jagga Aham Eva Atra Vihi Viho Vitan Vara. So, after explaining all these different items, Adhibhutam, Adhijagva, the super soul, the material creation, the Purushottam, everything. Then Krishna said, Artukalesa Mameva Smaran Mukta Khalivaram Japrayati Samadhavam Jati Nastatra Samsaya. This is the ultimate end of Krishna consciousness. That antakale, at the time of death, at the end of life, antakale is a mom unto me. Antakale is a mom eva. Secondly, smaran, remembering. The deity worship especially meant for this purpose, so that you go on worshipping the deity of Radha and Krishna, naturally you will be practiced to think of Radha Krishna always within your heart. This practice required. Antukali samamiva smaran. Mukta. This is the mukti. Mukti means no more material body. That is called mukti. We are now conditioned by this material body. In the material world, we are changing one body after another, but there is no mukti, there is no liberation. Mukti is simply by changing body, we are not mukta. Mukta means we need to change this body not to accept any more material body, but to remain in our own spiritual body. Just like if you are diseased, you are suffering from fever. So, when there is no more fever, but you remain in your original healthy body, that is called mukta. It is not that mukti means to become formless. No. The same example. You are suffering from fever. To become free from fever does not mean that you become formless. Why I shall become formless? My form is there, but my form is no more disturbed by the fever. Fever is condition. That is called mukta. Roga mukta. Free from disease. Therefore it is called mukta. Kalevaram. Just like the snake, these sometimes give up the outer covering of the body. Have you seen? But he remains in the body. He remains in the body. But the extra covering which he had grown, that is also grown. Once he gets up, everything, every education is there in the nature study. We can see the snake give up the covering, but he remains in his form. Similarly, we will muktu kalevaram, when this extra, just like this dress, this is covered. I can give it up, but I remain in my original body. Similarly, mukti means I have got my original body already. It is covered by this material coating. So when there is no more material coating, that is called mukti. That can be achieved when you go to Krishna, back to home, back to Godhead. At that time you do not become formless. Form remains. As I am individual form, similarly, when I go to Krishna, Krishna has also his individual form, I have also my individual form. Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam is the chief of all living entities. So, that is called mukti. So that mukti you can have if you can remember Krishna at the time of your death. So this is possible. If you have practiced to think of Krishna always, naturally, at the time of death, at the time of end of this body, if we are so fortunate to think of Krishna, his form, then we become materially free. No more this is Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. Practice. Japrayati samadhavam jati. Fourth chapter, I think, we have read that vituraga bhayakruda manvaya mamupasita bahavo jnana tapasa puta jati madhavam. That madhava, here it is said, japrayati. Anyone who is passing away, who is leaving this body, thinking of Krishna at the time of death, japrayati. So madhavam jati. Madhavam means spiritual nature. This spiritual world, this is also Krishna's world, but this is not the spiritual world. This is material world. We have already discussed that he has got two energies, material and spiritual. This material world is the manifestation of Krishna's material energy. Similarly, he has got a spiritual world also. Because his spiritual energy is also one of the energies. So madhavam jati means that spiritual energy, because Krishna remains in the spiritual world. That's what he says, madhavam, the spiritual nature. So this is the simple process. Antakalecha mameva smaran mukta kalivaram japrayati samadhavam. Jati, he goes, na asti atra samsaya. You do not doubt it. If you have taken Krishna as the supreme authority and Krishna says there is no doubt about it, then why should I become doubtful? Why can I disbelieve Krishna? This is the process. Chant Hare Krishna, always remember Krishna, and death may take place at any time. There is no guarantee that after so much time you die. At any moment you can die. Death, there is no guarantee. But it is a guarantee that you must die. That is guarantee. But when he will die, that is not guaranteed. Therefore, we must be prepared for death at any moment. Therefore, devotee is not afraid of death. He knows that death may come at any moment. He has Nowadays, death is very cheap, because we are using this motor car, these aeroplanes, so many things, seats and other things for transportation. And there is, every moment there is danger of accident, collapse, everything. So death is now very cheap. So we must be prepared for death at any moment. There is no guarantee that I am not yet old enough, I am not yet 8 years, 9 years, or shall I die? No. You may be 20 years, 25 years, or younger than that. Death is assured, and it can take place at any moment. Therefore, our only duty is to think of Krishna, Purushottama, so that we may die at any moment, but we become spiritual salvation. This is our only duty. We have no other duty. How to remember Krishna 24 hours? That is the greatest process of yoga perfection. Yoginamapi sarvesa madgatantanatma. Madgatantanatma. Always thinking of me. He is first class yogi. So this Hare Krishna Mahamantra is so nice that as soon as we chant Hare Krishna, immediately remember Krishna. Go on chanting, that means remembering. So in chanting, if there is death, so I am remembering Krishna, what is my fear? I am going to Krishna. Back to home, back to God. It is so nice. So always be engaged in Krishna consciousness, chant Hare Krishna mantra, then you are sure and safe. Not only in this life, but also you are going back to home, back to God. It is so nice. Thank you.